Our next inductee honed his early golf skills at the Selkirk Golf and Country Club and went on to win more than $2.4 million on the PGA Tour. In his amateur days, he played in the Western Canada Junior Team matches and the Manitoba Minnesota Junior matches in 1982, won the Manitoba Men's Amateur Championship in 1986, and played on three provincial Bullion Cup teams in 1985, 86, and 87. He was named Manitoba Amateur Golf of the Year in 1987. In his collegiate years, he was on the University of Southern Mississippi golf team from 1984 to 88, named to the All-Metro Conference team in 1988, had numerous top 10 finishes, won one individual championship, and was team captain in his senior year. He was inducted into the Southern Mississippi Sports Hall of Fame in 2003. As a pro on the local scene, he was Manitoba Assistant Pro Champion and MPGA Champion in 1989, placed second in the Manitoba Open in 1990, and seventh in the Manitoba Open in 1991. He was MPGA Player of the Year in 1989. His mini-tour career featured leading money winner on the Emerald Coast Tour in 1990, the winner of the Jackson Open on the U.S. Tour in 1990, and winner of the Disney World Tournament on the Spalding Space Coast Tour in 1993. In his rookie season on the Nationwide Tour in 1992, he won the Mississippi Gulf Coast Classic. He played 28 events on the Nationwide Tour in 1993. Then full seasons from 93 to 97, winning for the second and third times at the Carolina Classic and Utah Classic. He played full-time on the PGA Tour in 1998, winning $148,000. He won his fourth event on the Nationwide Tour, the Tri-Cities Classic, in 1999. He finished with $583,000 in career earnings on the Nationwide Tour. He was a full-time member of the PGA Tour in 2000 with two top 10s and five top 25s and $420,000 in earnings. In 2001, he had five top 25 finishes and more than $4,000 in earnings. In 2002, eight top 25s and led the St. Jude Classic for three rounds. And I'm sure many of us were glued to ABC's coverage of that event and won more than $500,000. Full-time PGA member in 2003, played only nine events in 2004 due to injury, was back on tour in 2005. He again played on the Nationwide Tour in 2006. Internationally, he teamed with Mike Weir to represent Canada in the 2000 EMC World Cup of Golf in Argentina. With a team total of 272, Canada placed ninth in the event, which is won by the U.S. team of Tiger Woods and David Duval. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome into the Manitoba Golf Hall of Fame, Glenn Natchuk.
First of all, I'd like to thank the Manitoba Golf Hall of Fame and Museum, Manitoba Lotteries, for having this event. Obviously, without them, we wouldn't have this wonderful event tonight. I'd like to thank Rudy Boivin and the nomination committee for allowing me to be here tonight. My golf started in Selkirk. I was born in Selkirk. If you don't know, it's about 30 minutes north of here. And I grew up playing a Selkirk Golf and Country Club. I have a group of gentlemen in the front row right there, all smiling. They know what Selkirk's all about. It all started for me when I was about 9 years old, and we had a group of gentlemen from Selkirk take us down to the bottom of the first hole and had us start chipping into inner tubes. And I'm gonna tell you right now, it's a great way to hone your short game. Try it. I did it while I was a professional. I kept on doing it, and honestly, it helps. But anyway, I played my first golf tournament when I was 10 years old. I played the Carmen Junior, and I won my age group. I shot 110, and I won by 66 shots. And somebody please research that and see if Tiger Woods has any kind of record like that. Let me know. But anyway, from then on, I was very, very, very hooked on competitive golf. I love playing, but more so than anything, I like playing tournament golf. At Selkirk, like I said, we had a group of gentlemen who really, really took care of us. We had a fantastic junior program there. We had a bunch of kids who loved to play. So there was always a game. And the group of gentlemen would always, we never really had formal lessons, but they would kind of pull us aside and give us tips here and there, and they were just wonderful. From there we moved on, they would take us to different inter-club competitions. You all are familiar with that, and obviously I played for Selkirk, and they were just a huge, huge influence on the beginning of my golf career. After that, I moved on to the Manitoba Golf Association, and I started playing the events around the province, the better junior tournaments and amateur tournaments, and I was very, very blessed enough to be able to win the 1986 Manitoba Amateur, and it was kind of at that point in time I thought that I might be able to play the game a little bit. I didn't think I was be able to play professionally. I never really thought that I was that good, but the Manitoba Amateur gave me a little bit of a springboard. I was in the middle of my college career, and it did give me some confidence. The Wellington Cup teams were huge for me. I know there's some of the club captains are here. Al, we went to one together, and those were a great experience. You build relationships through those kind of tournaments, and that's something that you're never going to forget. I'd like to thank my family who are here tonight. My mom, my dad. My dad's not with us. He passed away in 2008, but I know that he would be very, very proud of this moment, knowing how supportive he was through everything that I did. This is definitely for him. My mom, my dad, my brothers were always very, very supportive. Did I come from a golfing family? If you ask my brothers, they'd probably say yes. But if you watched them play, you'd probably say no. Okay. Growing up, they didn't play a whole lot. My mother never played, my dad never played, my brothers played, a little bit. They play a lot more now than they used to. In fact, I think we played a couple summers ago, and I think they both beat me. So I consider them really good players, actually, now. Very good players. But again, they were all very, very supportive in whatever I did. And again, that's something that I'll never forget. My wife and my two daughters were not able to make it. I live in Florida, just north of Tampa, Florida, so they're in school, and it's just kind of a long way to come. But as far as my professional career is concerned, they're a huge part of that. I know that for some of you who know kind of what professional golf is all about, it's not near as glamorous as people think. They see Tiger Woods and they see Phil Mickelson, and they fly in private jets, and that's kind of what it's all about. Well, it's not what it's all about. It's more about families dragging their young kids through airports, flying commercially, trying to find the cheapest hotels to stay in to save on expenses. So that's what a lot of it's about. And I really, my wife was a rock, and you really have to have somebody special to kind of drag through, all those traveling times. So I'm very, very fortunate to have somebody like her. In closing, I'd first of all like to congratulate the rest of the inductees. You should be very, very proud of your accomplishments, and I'm honored to be on this stage with you all. I feel very blessed to be able to have played golf for a career, something that I love doing, and was able to do it for a living. And again, I feel very, very fortunate to be able to play golf. I also am very honored and very humbled to receive this tonight. And I think the one thing that I learned most, especially through my professional career, is that you cannot build a career, let alone a successful career, by yourself. It takes help, it takes support. And I want to thank Manitoba for always being supportive for me. Thank you.